Good morning, everyone. Today, we are here to discuss regarding the very first topic in our subject, that is the multimedia networks. As you all know, the subject title is multimedia communication. So before we're moving on to multimedia networks, we'll first see what is this multimedia stage. So now we all know what is communication. Transferring of information from one point to another point is called as communication. So next, multimedia. So before going to multi, we'll see what is media. Anything that is used to transfer the information is known as media. So in media types, we have four types of media types. The first one is text. In text, we have unformatted and formatted. Next is the second type of media is images. We have images and pictures. In pictures, we'll come across the graphics or some drawings that you'll be using any of the software such as Paint or something. Next, we have audio. In audio, we have high, low fidelity audio and high fidelity audio. Low fidelity audio is the transmission of the speech information, that is, now whatever I am speaking, that comes under low fidelity. And high fidelity includes the transmission of the music, that is, which includes all the stereophonic music along with those, you see the along with the vocals, we have so many instruments, so that is, that comes under high fidelity. Next we have the video. The last type of the video type is video. In video, again, we have video clips and the movies. Video clips are those short length videos of around 2 to 5 minutes at the max. And these movies, as the name indicates, movies, the length of the movie may extend from around 1.5 to 2.5 hours. So now we have four types of media types as we discussed now, that is text, image, audio and video. The combination of two or more media types, the discussed four of the media types, the combination of any two or more of the four media types, we'll call it as multimedia. That is, if you are sending, combining audio and video and you are sending it as a single file, then it comes under multimedia. We have a chapter on multimedia applications where we'll be studying the applications of the multimedia, the combination of the permutations and combinations of all these four media types discussed here. So now, as I told, multimedia is a combination of two or more media types. So now we'll require different types of networks to transmit those multimedia data. So now we have broadly classified the multimedia networks into five types. The first one is telephone networks, data networks, broadcast television networks, ISDN, which can be expanded as integrated services digital networks, and broadband multi-service networks. So now what are these networks in detail, we'll be going to discuss in the next session. So now the very first network, as you see, saw in the previous slide, that is telephone network component. This is the block diagram or the network component of the telephone networks. See, you have a PBX here, that is called as private branch exchange. To this private branch exchange, all the local telephones will be connected. We have the local exchanges here, all the PBXs will be connected to local exchanges. This PBX actually acts as, this PBX will be installed in separate offices, for a single office or in a different larger office or a site, you can have this PBX to which all the telephones in that particular office will be connected. And then that PBX will be directly connected to the local exchange. This local exchange will also have the direct connection from the telephone that we are using at our homes or in the small businesses. And then we have this IGs, that is International Gateway Exchanges. These International Gateway Exchanges are used for routing of the international calls, that is the calls that come from the other nations. And this GMSC, it is actually cellular phone network. Whatever I have discussed here, PBX, local exchange and the IGs, these usually local exchange and PBX, they usually correspond for the wireline networks, wired networks. In this GMSC, the cellular phone network is actually the mobile network, that is the wireless form of network. Again, the CMSC is connected to the public, to the network over here. All these together, that is the PBX, local exchange, IGE, GMSC, all these together will form into a small, into a wider network called as PSTN. And now as we are moving on to the digitizing networks, we are digitizing everything. So now we are trying to digitize this telephone networks also, to which we are using the modems. These modems, they convert the analog data into digital data, and on the other side, second to the vice versa. So that is, it converts the digital data into analog data. And this figure shows the implementation of a high-speed modem here. As I told, for the conversion between the analog and the digital, we have a high-speed modem. Compared to this regular modem, it will have only one channel here. But these high-speed modems will have two channels. One is the low bitrate telephone channel and the other one is the high bitrate telephone channel. Low bitrate telephone channel, which is used for the telephony conversations. And this high bitrate channels, they are used for telecasting the, you know, TV data, for example, or transmission of the video or some audio signals from other to other. So the next type of network is data networks. This data network is nothing but they are used to provide the internet networks. As you can see here, we have a global internet backbone network. To that, we have three separate networks here. Here, the one we have is the enterprise-wide private network. Then the other one is regular site or campus line, or this is the ISP. This internet service provider is used actually at the homes or the small businesses where we have only two or more systems. The home system or the small business system will be directly connected to the ISP, and the ISP will be connected to the global internet backbone network through a gateway. And again, you have a site or campus LAN. For example, if we are studying in a college or in a smaller company, they'll have a LAN network and they'll provide internet connectivity to all the systems that are provided, that are available in that particular campus. So in that case, we'll be using the site or campus LAN. And this enterprise-wide private network that is used where, in case we have some multinational companies which will have branches in all around the world. So in all around the world, for example, they have a branch in Chennai, they have a branch in Mumbai. So there will be a separate LAN in Chennai, there will be a separate branch in LAN in Mumbai. In all in order to connect the LANs that is present in the Chennai office and the Mumbai office, together they form what is called as an enterprise-wide network. So the internet connectivity can also be made possible using these cable network. And these cable networks, they come under the broadcast television networks. As we all know, this is the older model of the cable networks where you used to have a antenna at the one end, and there used to be a cable operator who used to come provide the connection to us, and they used to come and collect everything on the piece. This is the general block diagram of the cable network. And later on we moved on to the satellite transmissions. So this is a block diagram of a satellite television network. Next we have is the alternate services provided by ISDN. As the name indicates, this is integrated services digital network. So the entire network is totally digitized. And in this ISDN, we can provide n number of services depending upon the channel that we will be using. For example, you have generally you will have 64 kbps channels, 164 kbps channels, and you will have 128 kbps channels. If you want a range of services between them, that is the ISDN that can actually provide services up to 2 mbps. But we will not have along with having one single 2 Mbps channel here, we also have this P into 64 Kbps switched channel, where this P will vary from 1 to 30. So that between 64 Kbps and these 2 Mbps, if you want any services that offers the bitrate in between those two, that is 64 Kbps and 2 Mbps, you can use this channel varying the P from 1 to n, that is equal to 30. And last type we have is ATM broadband multi-service networks. These are used to offer the services, to such networks or channels that require the data rate greater than 2 Mbps actually. So here we have ATM LANs, ATM MANs and everything. And all these are connected by n number of LANs are connected to an ATM MAN using an inter-working unit called as IW. ITM LANs are usually reserved for the smaller sites, and all the LANs from the different sites are connected to the ATM MANs. That's all regarding the multimedia networks. In the next class, before going to the next class, you have a quiz followed here, the knowledge quiz and assimilation and the reflection quiz. Students, you need to attend all those, and those will be graded actually. And in the following lecture, and I also shared this PowerPoint presentation in the Moodle site of mine. You can access this PPT if you need some. And in the next class, we'll be discussing about different multimedia applications, as I already discussed.